Hello, welcome to Wing Algia. I'm not pronouncing that right. So this is also called The Little Shop or Wing. Now, this game has had enough updates, so I just wanted to check back on it because I love this genre and I play it when I'm, I don't know, a little stressed or I don't want to play something serious or stressful. So let's see what they added. This is my original shop, which was in, I don't know, year 2, day 1. Now, as you can see, I've done most of the things in the initial game, so now we can just advance the content very, very fast. Actually, I'll play a bit with the new things around here and then I'll go start the new game because I want to see how the new game experience has improved. Because this is a finished game, all I have to do now is just add more money to it. One of the biggest features people asked for was the ability to replenish stocks with a single click. And yes, they did that. So as you can see, you have a lot of slots in here. And also you don't have to go to the circular menu anymore. So you can lock them down like this, for each slot separately. So let's say I take all of them out. They have all sold, so then let's replenish them. Simple button press of the R key. Perfect, everyone wanted that feature. Another thing they really added and was good is they expanded on the crafting and of course the... That's strange. That didn't happen before, this was perfectly tailored for maximum efficiency. They expanded the planting and of course they added a new crafting. And the new crafting is of course, you guessed it, cooking. Now let's see, what is the stove? It's in crafting. By the way, this is one of the best graphics I ever seen for a cooking table in any game. That looks delicious. Any way you look at it, it's delicious. Let's put that there because again, this was optimized and I played a lot with it. Again, it looks pretty much... I can't stop looking at it, it's so delicious. So we can make a vegetable soup with asparagus and artichokes and beans and cauliflower and... Oh, so I can make them with any of those ingredients? Okay, so I'm making the soup with artichokes currently. How do you decide with what ingredient you would want to make the soup? Bread? I guess the vegetable soup can be made with any of those ingredients and you get a higher value out of them. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's how it's working. So this is the special cooking quest line. Item of... I can make now a decent bread. Oh well, that's cute. Well, I still have to click a lot of times. Oh, shift. Perfect, they even fixed that one. That was another big complaint. So shift or cutlet to buy more of the item. So can I do shift? No, I can't do that here. So let's advance the skill tree a bit more. Apple pie. This is just amazing. Look at the beautiful graphics here. By the way, they added a fancy graphic settings. That's why the game is looking better. Fancy graphic setting is right here. Without it, it looks kind of bland. With it, it looks much better. Not a huge improvement, but again, it looks much better, much more cleaner, organic-like. And the effects for all the crafting stations are very nice. Okay, so what else did they add? They added bigger planters that I didn't unlock because they are kind of locked, I think. I don't know, let me see. Yeah, they are locked, I have to unlock them. But you can just check them out a bit. Where are they? Oh yeah, here they are. So I need to complete the objective in order to unlock them. So this is basically the same planter, but it has two slots in it. And this has four slots in it. And I think it works on the same restock principle as the other shells. This will greatly increase your vegetable production. Also, you can unlock the shells, which I don't have right now, because again, this is an older save and it's not really compatible with the current build of the game. So you also have shelves that you can mount on the walls. So now you can, let's say, put a table here and then put a shelf on the wall, which is great. The game really needed that. Double rustic shelf. Oh, so you can have also a double shelf. And there are a lot more things they changed or they added. I mean, they added the apple pie recipe, they added the meat stew, we have the vegetables too. And I think they added another recipe. Anyway, they added the entire quest lines for this one, and now it's actually a lot harder to advance. But I'll show that when I play the normal game, when I start a new game. Other than that, there are a huge number of changes, smaller or bigger, that are quality of life improvements, as you saw. So let's play for about 10 minutes the normal game. Yeah, I need a break. So let's make a new shop. I played a bit with it. Let's play on the normal game. Sure, let's override the save. I hope I didn't override my bigger save. No, I think I know how to play the game. I hope so. So you start out with a little shop, in case you didn't know the game. So let's start from the beginning. I want to see the new experience. You see those footsteps? They have to be... You have to be able to reach them. So that means you can't put it like this. Okay, let's try to make this a faster gameplay, because I just want to test the new game. And besides, the game will get much more content, many more improvements, because this is still early access. And I can't complain too much about early access. What can you do? It is what it is. I'm just happy we have this game and it's going the right way. I mean, yeah, I want some combat, I want some more active stuff to do like in the other games, but even if they don't add them, this will be the best shopkeeper simulator ever made, because it has everything we wished for. Well, at least the people that played shopkeeper simulators. You have to be a little on the line with this one. Can I fit one more in? No, of course not. I can't fit one more. So let's open the door. This will be the hammer. Hammer time. Short. Tunic time. Apples and of course wood. So easy to restock right now. So each day we have to expand our shop and of course you have to buy ingredients. They are very expensive if you buy this from the counter, and it depends on the season. Food is cheaper, so that means you can sell a lot more food from the counter. If not, you can just use the merchant to restock whenever he comes by. Since we don't have a lot of room, we can't buy all the things we want, so let's start too little by little. Another thing that I added before was you have the ability to pick what items to sell. So for example, if you stock all your items, all your shelves and tables and whatever with crafted items like swords, hammers, axes, pitchforks and stuff like that, they'll eventually only buy those items. Which can be very good, because you can actually choose to make a shop with only blacksmithing items, or with only food items, or only with clothing items, clothes. So yeah, that's the beauty of the game. But wow, they really made the game a lot more pretty. Do it, we have no customers left. Shop value has increased by a little bit. Open the door. So, as you saw in my in my first save, this shop can be expanded to the maximum. Oh, I unlocked pallet. Buy more apples, they are good for you, healthy. Yeah, it's a lot easier to do restocks now. And the circular menu is finally gone. You don't want to buy as soon as it gets here, you want... Well, I'm a bit in a rush anyway, so you can't buy furniture during the daytime. So I'll just have to wait until they buy something. and then see what they need. He can wait, he is not in a rush. Right, old man? Right. Ah, the game looks a little crispier. Oh, that's a bug. Wait, buy items, don't. I think that's a bug. I think I read something about that. People not wanting to buy the items even though they are on display. Hammer, tunic. So easy. It's so easy to restock right now. Another thing they changed, and I really like the new changes. Here, let's close the day. This seems to be a little bug here. They should close the door if you don't have any customers. When you upgrade your shop, it gets more and more expensive the more you build. So 21, 24, 27, 35. So let's try to make a medium shop. We will cancel after that. Yeah. So this will cost us a lot of money. So this will be 5,000 coins or whatever, 5,000 money. And to upgrade to the final version of the shop, you need much more than this. So yeah, they fixed also the upgrading. So now it's a lot harder to upgrade your shop. Yeah, of course I don't have money. And it's also a lot more fun, and this seems a lot more natural. See the lines? Perfect, so let's pick up a pallet. Even though we don't have enough storage, but hey, let's do a little one. Actually, let's build it on the right side, on the left side. And that's about everything I can afford, so let's wait for new customers. I could have made a new table, but not really needed. I only have 4 items. So that increased my storage capabilities by a little bit. Here you go, an apple for you, sir. You can also order during the daytime, but it will take a while until they arrive. So your best option is just to buy from people like this one. Spend all your money, because I want to sell more hammer, so let's put one more hammer. Actually, don't do that. Fine, I'll buy some wood for you. Especially, you want to sell them, because they actually made a new kind of system that I really like. If you sell more items to them, they'll actually buy more items. So if I give her wood, then she has a chance of buying something else, because she'll be very happy. Or she'll come back the next day and buy more stuff. So easy right now, so fluent. Look at those beautiful butterflies. So the season's events are much better explained right now, and yeah, it's everything is better and you have new content. I can make a table or either a shelf. So they snap on. Wow. It does look a lot better like this. And yeah, you basically have one more set of tiles, so you don't have to upgrade your shop like I did in the beginning. Just add shelves and it will be fine. But now I can't afford the crafting station. Okay, let's play another day or two. That's incredible. I don't want to spoil the fun, but you saw most of the updates and the quality of life changes. Well, that's a real man. He bought 2 hammers. One is for working around the house, and the other one is as a spare, I think. Also, when you level up, you automatically unlock new items, so you don't have to pay for them like in the beginning. You level up, you unlock a new item, you can use it. I mean, in the beginning you have to pay to unlock the item and then pay to place it, so that was kind of an unnecessary thing. Nice, thank you for buying all my hammers. I'm making a lot of money. So let's buy more hammers. So if it has minus something, it's best to buy it. If it has plus, don't step near it. So my hammer shop is advancing at a rapid pace. The controls are so fluent right now. I'm loving it. let's do it. We also paid our debt, so we barely have enough money to allocate to put down the crafting station, which is be the tailoring one. Such a tiny shop, I love it. You know what they say? Start small, get big. Survive three random events, yeah, that'll be hard. Bandits? This is a new event. This may affect traders. I think it's a new event because I never got that one when I last played. So as you can see, his happiness is 2 pluses. So that means he'll buy more items or, I don't know, he'll come more often. Yeah, I actually needed some wood and some tunics. I think apples are too cheap to buy anyway, so... let's stock up on the other items. Also, now we can craft, so no money left. Yeah, I feel that. That happens to me sometimes too. No money left. So once again, I think you should be able to expand your shop at a decent rate right now. But the difficulty system actually... The difficulty system will actually make things a lot harder now. Well, I guess I'm too excited for this game. Too bad I don't have enough time to play it. Okay, let's buy a few linen pieces. So, the more you craft, the better you craft the items. So, you start with cheap items and then you upgrade them to legendary status. And after that, they sell for a lot higher, very high price. So, it's better to craft your own items. Or to buy them very cheap and sell them very expensive. But again, it's a lot more profitable to have your own items and upgrade them in the process. Okay, let's craft the tunics and let's make some, I don't know, play some other things. But for now, I just want to focus on making money and reaching level 5. Sorry, I'm reading everything right here. I think there are some new events over there. How many improvements did the game get, anyway? No, don't buy them because you'll craft them. And the hammers are way too expensive for my budget. Oh, they also added the sprint button. She runs around the shop. Well, that's cute. Okay, I don't know why that's happening, but it's annoying. They really like my hammers. Okay, get away from me. You have bad prices. I don't like it. So yeah, I think that's because of the event. He has less items to sell me. And a worse price. So that doesn't overwrite the number, does it? It does not. Okay, close the shop. I think this is a problem. I hope they fix it. Okay, so what would we... yeah, let's buy some decoration. So you can buy... yeah, I usually buy only tulip bouquets like this one and just place them all over. They still need to fix this one because this is kind of an exploit, I feel. Just buy all the cheap ones and place them all over the place. Even though this was nerfed because now it's actually more expensive to upgrade your shop. That was level 3, and some of the quests will actually give you money. Let's see... yeah, here you can see your quests. Survivor, net value... well, that's a lot of rewards. You get trousers. Okay, let's unlock trousers. And I should add some storage pallets. Stock capacity is almost at maximum. Nice, I got some money for that, so let's buy some other storage things. Your appeal increases the number of customers, I think. And other than that, we are almost broke. So let's play one more day and then I'll end the video. Yeah, at this point I should have more tables for my clothes. So that would be a tunic. Tunic table. I don't have enough money, but we can just wait a bit more. We can buy that one. Yeah, now everyone wants to buy my hammers. So expensive, it's... Actually, let's see, 22 silver. And for how much they sell? 25. That's still worth it in a way, kind of. I think they also have a system that you can see their prices, but I'm not sure how that works yet. So this table is level 1 and you can see all the stats. Oh, I think she left. The lady that wanted the hammer. Hillebrand. And we also unlocked the old cupboard, so now we can build it. Excuse me. What is the lazy cat? What is the lazy cat? Oh, it's a picture. Of a cat. That's so nice. Trash bin decoration. I'll have to use that. So that's a new decoration. It will go on the wall. Perfect. And yeah, now we have the double shelves, which are actually... Yeah, they're more economic than the shelves. 66. The tables are still the most... Yeah, they're not so expensive. Two slots for 44 or two slots for 66. But it doesn't use your other... Oh, nice. So this is the best way to exit. Okay. This is perfect. This is exactly what the game needed. So that's why I'm following this game, because they add only the stuff that people want and they actually improve their game. So and this will be full release. I bet this game will be one of the best shopkeeper simulators, if not the best. Well, that's it for now. See you in the next update. Bye.